Boss, can I just say what an honour it is to be working on a day like this?
The what?
To be working on the day the new Valka range comes out. I mean, I've dreamt of this moment before.
Has he taken the piss?
He's just, enthusiastic.
And in a dream, it was called the latent range, but apart from that, it's exactly the same.
Great.
And if there's anything you need, I'm right here. I'm right here.
Actually, there's a point of sale needs putting up in the entrance for no nonsense. I want it to be the first thing people see when they come in.
Really? The first thing?
I want John Customer to say, great, no nonsense about bastard time. You'll find the stuff in my office, so...
Right. But don't worry, I'm all over it. 6,000%.
All right, Leighton.
I keep telling you, it's Leighton. Leighton.
Setting up a new display?
Yeah. I've been entrusted to set up the display for the new range, and I'm not sure, but I think it might be the proudest moment of my life.
Yeah, it probably is. See you later. Later.
Leighton. It's Leighton. It even says it on my badge. L-E-I-G-H-T-O-N. Leighton. Leighton.
All sense. What happened to the middle bit?
Some of the letters were missing, so I thought I'd use some initiative.
And how the frig is that, using initiative?
Well, it's a good question. Thank you for asking. Well, I thought that since it can't say no nonsense, I thought I might just leave a gap here so it looks like no nothing sense. Which is, you know, pretty similar to no nonsense, and I don't want to get carried away, but maybe we should suggest that all branches do it like that.
Yeah, I'll phone head office now.
You do that. Can I go and call my mum? I got to call my mum.
Any thicker, and we could sell him as double green.
Easy, Tiger.
Where did the balls go?
Well, in the pockets. And then into another dimension. Oh, hello.
Serious?
Ah, hello. That's it. Let me just give you a hand with that. You just feel the pressure. That's it.
Can I have a go?
What?
Can I have a go?
No, we're just lining up another shot here. I'll follow it through. That's it. That's it. Oh. And then that's it. And stand up again.
Thank you. Yes, I'm quite good at this.
Fancy seeing how it's really done, son.
Okay, if you win, you have to play the next person. Colin said that's the rules. I've been here all morning. I haven't even had a wee.
I won't keep you two ticks. You are looking at the St. Helens pool champ, 82 to 83.
You've played pool for a whole year. That's amazing, Andy.
And balls must be weighted. Let's play another.
My arms ache, Andy.
Young arms like yours should be able to keep going all day.
My arms are 23 like me. That's quite old in arm years.
That's the trouble with young guys these days. No stamina, no staying power, no loyalty. Right, come on, sunshine, we're playing again. Oh, bollocks.
2 hour break. I knew even you couldn't eat for that long.
2 hours? Never. My watch must have gone.
And that clock up there, Jimmy White, that's not gone.
I'm sorry, Lorraine. The lad asked me to teach him how to play pool.
I don't pay you to play pool. So put that cue down and get back to pissing work.
Thank you. Thank you.
That's a foul, but because it was your last ball, technically it's a win for me. Better luck next time, sunshine.
Baked beans? Baked beans. Tomato soup? Tomato soup? How does it do that? How does it do that? How does it... Hello, sir. Hey, well, hang on a second. I think there's a 2-for-1 on these. Yeah, it's 2-for-1. Go and get another one. It's free. It's free!
Who did you think those lads were, Leighton?
Well, I did ask them a couple of times, and they said they were 30. But I thought, if you can't buy a drink when you're 30, when can you buy a drink?
They were in school uniform. What were you thinking?
I was thinking about my old school uniform. They've swapped the badge, it's on a different side now.
Hello. Hi.
Oh, here he is. The comeback kid, like a phoenix risen from the ashes.
Hello. Hello, hi.
Good to have you back, Leighton.
It's good to be back, to be honest. I'd started to wonder if Valco had all been just like a really brilliant dream I'd had, but it's not. It's real, all right? It's all real. Hello.
Oh, Leighton. Oh, I saw you were on the road today. Oh, it's good to have you back.
Yeah. Julia, I just wanted to say, I know it wasn't your fault sacking me. I know it wasn't you.
Right, thanks.
She's really horrible, isn't she?
It would be highly unprofessional of me to call another member of the management team a nasty, mean-spirited, controlling old bitch. So I'm afraid I couldn't possibly comment.
All right. Loud and clear. I couldn't possibly comment either.
Anyway, best make yourself useful and pack some bags before the ice queen captures you.
Okay, yeah. I'm all over it like a pair of shoes. I'm doing this in my mum's kitchen, but I just didn't get the same buzz. She doesn't stock enough cornflakes. In fact, she doesn't stock any because me and my brother aren't allowed high glycemics.
You know, I could just not when I was just thinking about her, man.
My mum?
No.
You're thinking about her again, aren't you?
There is no her. You're talking shit, mate.
Looks like you're in need of Leighton's love formula.
Like a bullet in the bollocks.
Yeah. So try to imagine you're both travelling at the speed of light. Where are you going?
Got my own technique, can I? It's tried and tested, mate. Just like that. I couldn't even get a semi.
No way.
There must be something wrong with me.
You're like Wally.
What?
You know, the robot that tidies stuff up and falls in love with another robot?
No, I haven't seen it, mate.
Oh, it's amazing.
Yeah?
Yeah. It made me want to be a robot for a while, but then I realised robots don't watch films, so if I was to be a robot, then I wouldn't be able to watch Wally.
How slow are you two? Like watching a couple of monkeys trying to unpack a suitcase.
Well, usually we would have been done by now, but Colin's in it.
Oh, he's a fucking wind-up merchant, this one.
A couple of dog sticks.
Oh, my God, I've just realised.
I swear, you say one word.
Well, he did watch films. So I could still be a robot if I wanted.
Yes. Such a freak.
Oh, and don't worry, I won't tell anybody you're in love with Lisa.
Oi, you. You're lummox. You're not at the Early Learning Centre now. Plonk those down and follow us.
Where are we going?
Well, I'm going to crack a few heads today, and I might as well start with yours. Not that I'm expecting to find anything inside it.
Don't worry, ladies. It's just a routine check, that's all.
Is it about the nits? I promise I haven't got nits. I even wash my hair in vinegar just to make sure.
Don't worry, Elton Leighton, between me and you, never plonk. Always place.
Oh, yeah, just like you told me.
So, this is the Bat Cave, is it?
I prefer to call it Leighton's Locker.
Well, I think we can presume that none of this has come off the shop floor.
Actually, Gavin, some of it has come off the shop floor.
Told you so. Shine a bright light on our rat and he'll soon start squealing.
This tangerine net came off the shop floor and I was going to throw it in the bin, but then I thought it was perfect for my collection of power balls.
What's that at the back? That is a Valco tin.
This? It's the last tin of spaghetti faces. It's a collector's item.
Oh, well, I never. I haven't seen one of these for 3 years.
How do we know you didn't pinch it?
I kept the receipt, March 2009.
I'm glad you did. I love these old receipts. The ink threads back then were much more stable. Look. Sorry to keep you waiting, everyone. It's just complete mayhem on soft produce. I mean, how Julie managed with just two hands, I really don't know. Anyway, today is one of the key dates in the Valco calendar, the fire drill. And if... Sorry, Leighton, what are you wearing?
My bike stuff. Just in case we have a real fire before the fire drill and you don't have time to give us our proper fire warden vests.
Right, moving on. I know things have been a little bit off kilter, what with Julie being off and Lorraine's rather sudden departure, but I'm sure if we all pull together as a team, we can make this the best, the most efficient fire drill that this branch of Valco has ever seen.
Come on!
Gavin, can I just ask a quick question?
No, I know what you're going to ask there, Kieran, and the answer's yes. Yes, I do think we can beat the 2008 evacuation time of 3 minutes and 15 seconds.
I was actually just going to ask when we get the extra money.
Oh, there's no money in this, Kieran. Who told you that?
No one.
So the vidal starts at 12:30, so you've got a little bit of time to familiarise yourselves with the equipment. Now, it's the holy trinity of the whistle and the torch. And the hive is tabard. Oh, I tell you, boys. Oh, the fun I've had with these torches. Oh, yes. Gavin Strong! Oh, well, not really. I'm holding fort at Warrington. Shut up! No, sorry, no, not you. No.
You okay, Gavin?
Oh, sorry. Leighton, I'm miles away. Just thinking that if that fire had been real, I'd be ringing Marcus Allen now and telling him that his beloved wife had perished in a fire.
Shall I ring him for you?
It's very kind of you, Leighton, but it wasn't a real fire, was it?
But I thought you said we should act like it was.
I think telling Allen that his wife's dead when she isn't is a little overzealous. That's no good, I can't get out of my head. I've let Margaret down. I've let Valco down. I know what I must do.
Your arm's made out of lead. You should be finished here.
I'm sorry, Julie, there's been something of an error, and I don't want to tell you what the error was.
Oh, for goodness sake, do I constantly have to change your nappy?
I'm not wearing a nappy.
Look, well, just tell me what's happened.
Instead of putting the no-nonsense items on the no-nonsense shelf, I put the treat-yourself items on the no-nonsense shelf.
Well, just move them.
Why can't? The customers have bought them all.
People have bought treat-yourself items off the no-nonsense stand.
No, and they took the no-nonsense items at the same time. It's crazy.
A spoonful of sugar, Leighton.
Who would buy that?
No, what I mean is, a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. Poppins?
Poppins.
Look, people are buying no-nonsense because it's cheap. So, to make themselves better, they're buying treat-yourself at the same time. Understand?
Yeah.
Oh, Leighton, I think you might have just found the magic formula.
Abracadabra.